2020-21, and it is my honor to welcome you to the first virtual and 63rd Founders Day of Vallum Girls School, Dehradun. Before starting any auspicious event, we seek the blessings of the Almighty by invoking Him. Thank you, choir. I would now like to request Mrs. Padmini Sambasivam, Principal Vallum Girls School, to share the annual report for this year.
One and all, it feels very strange to be standing on an empty stage and making this speech. Founders Day is a time when the campus is brimming with high energy and addictive joy. And fortunately this year, I'm standing at the podium facing an empty auditorium, wishing each one of you was with us here in person. But Vallum is an institution has always looked for and focused on that one silver lining, even in the darkest of times, and emerged shining and stronger. This pandemic has been no different in that sense. COVID-19 made us look at things differently. When the lockdown was announced on the 21st of March, we took stock of the situation and declared summer holidays. We took our time to plan and prepare ourselves to rise to the occasion as a team. Our natural inclination to adapt and learn came in handy. And within 3 weeks, our teachers were able to initiate online learning. This is the first opportunity our parents have had in the history of Vellum to actually experience and be a part of all their children's activity, which otherwise would be limited to occasional visits for events such as Founders Day. As you all are aware, we have managed as a team to offer all the planned activities in the calendar, keeping in mind the interest of every child. Our tadpoles, as we affectionately refer to our students, have used every opportunity offered with equal enthusiasm and zeal. I'm indeed proud of each one of them and their achievements, in spite of the many odds that they have had to face. Today, we celebrate our 63rd Founders Day, first of its kind virtually, and I'm delighted to welcome amidst us a familiar personality, the Iron Woman, a woman of substance, Ms. Vinita Bali, who so kindly agreed to be the chief guest for this year's Founders Day. Ms. Bali is not a new face for us. She's been the president of the Vellum Girls School Society for the last 6 years, and under her dynamic leadership, we have made giant strides, not just in terms of academic, co- and extracurricular performances, but in terms of the school infrastructural development, staff welfare and professional development, and in embedding technology and spirit of sustainability as a way of life. To me personally, these 5 years with her will be one of the most memorable years of my professional life. It has been one of constant learning, and it has helped me evolve into a better leader and an individual as well. Vinita Bali is a global business leader with extensive experience in leading large companies, both in India and overseas. She has worked with eminent multinationals, and with her Midas touch, she has turned around every company that she's been a part of. Vellum is no exception. Under Ms. Bali's able guidance, every institution finds its golden era. Vellum experienced the same. Welcome and thank you, Ms. Bali, for being with us the last 6 years, especially today. I'm very happy to share with you that Mr. Deepak Kapoor has now taken over as president of Vellum Girls School Society. Mr. Kapoor is the former chairman and CEO of PwC India. He took retirement from PwC in December 2016 after having been associated with it for 39 years. Mr. Kapoor is the chairman of Save the Children in India and serves on a number of boards of large corporates as independent director. Post his retirement from PwC, Mr. Kapoor has joined as independent director on the boards of Tata Steel and HCL Technology. I'm sure that under his leadership, Vellum will move forward in leaps and bounds. Welcome to the Founders Day celebrations, Mr. Kapoor. Mrs. Neelu Khanna, social activist and co-founder of Asra Trust, has been on our board for the last 3 years, and she now takes over as vice president of the Board of Governors. Mrs. Khanna has been a constant support to the school, and as a member of the campus subcommittee, helped see several campus projects to fruition. Welcome, Mrs. Neelu Khanna. This year, along with Ms. Bali, another member of the board retired, Dr. Meenakshi Gopinath, an eminent educationist and former principal of LSR, retired after 6 years of serving on our board. Dr. Gopinath's contribution will always be remembered. On behalf of the board, staff, students, and management, I'm happy to welcome all the members of the board, current and former. We'd like to specially welcome two new members, Mr. Jayanth Krishna and Mrs. Vasvi Bharat Ram. Mr. Jayanth Krishna is the Group Chief Officer, UK India Business Council, and comes with the expertise of managing large organizations. He possesses a diverse experience in the field of skill development, IT, and this the board shall definitely benefit from his vast experience. Mrs. Vasvi Bharat Ram is the joint chairperson of the Sri Ram Schools, and we look forward to her expertise as an educationist and to add value to the school. Welcome, ma'am. I'd also like to welcome Mrs. Brar, former principal, Wellham Girls School, members of the society and alumni, other distinguished invitees, parents, staff, and my dear students. I'd now like to take you through the school annual report, which has already been shared with you all. I'm sharing the highlights of our success story and achievements. We are proud to announce the stupendous results of the academic year 2019-20. 76 students appeared for the ISE examination and 38 of them scored above 95%, and our class average was 94.03%. Our toppers, Janvi Chandra and Tanisha Gupta, scored 99.5%. The Khandelwal Shield for highest aggregate in ISE examination goes to Aureole 400 Janvi Chandra and Flycatcher 336 Tanisha Gupta. Congratulations, girls. We are also happy to share with you that our students secured 100% in several subjects. Six students secured 100% in history, and the Miss Linnell Memorial Gold Medal for highest percentage in history in the ISE examination 2020 goes to Janvi Chandra, Janvi Ghai, Sasha Serene, Tanisha Gupta, Sarah Baines, and Anurati Garg. Congratulations, girls. We are happy to announce 14 students secured 100% in political science, and the Devdutt Prize for the highest percentage in political science in the ISE examination 2020 goes to Anmol Kejriwal, Preksha Jalan, Dia K. Tripal, Manal Mirza, Meher Sekhon, Ishita Bhargava, Janvi Chandra, Grima Agarwal, Sasha Serene, Tanisha Gupta, Sarah Baines, Anurati Garg, Tanvi Trihan, and Sakshi Bajoria. Well done. Three students secured 100% in economics and the Kuwar Bridge Bhushan Cup for the highest percentage in economics in ISE examination goes to Aureole 400 Janvi Chandra, Woodpecker 701 Ishita Bhargava, and Woodpecker 156 Gaurika Bansal. Well done, girls. Nine students secured 100 in mathematics, and many secured 100% in several subjects such as home science, geography, psychology, and accounts. A class 10 students were equally successful, and out of a total of 82 students, 74 students scored above 90%. A class average was 93.46%. Woodpecker 094, Krisha Khanna scored 98.6% and topped the batch. She receives the Saraswati Vasanmal Trophy for the highest aggregate in the ICSE examination 2020. It is our constant endeavor to appreciate and encourage the academic achievements of our students at various levels. I'm proud to share that all our students strive very hard to receive these coveted prizes, and it is always a stiff competition among the several deserving students. I'd now like to share the names of this year's achievers in the Mahindra Search for Talent Scholarship. This year, the award goes to, for Class 8, Oriel 097, Chitrangada Tiwari, Class 9, Flycatcher 444, Himanshi Gupta, in Class 10, Woodpecker 094, Krisha Khanna, in Class 11, Flycatcher 131, Palak Agarwal, and Bulbul 160, Dia Gupta. Very well done and congratulations, girls. The Mahindra Verma Trophy for highest aggregate in Commerce Stream goes to Flycatcher 377, Krisha Manocha. The Faculty Trophy for Sustained Academic Standard in the Humanities Stream goes to Bulbul 255, Saumya Saraf. Congratulations. The Faculty Trophy for Sustained Academic Standard in the Science Stream goes to Flycatcher 131, Palak Agarwal again. We now move on to the co-curricular awards. The school offers over 20 activities as part of their co-curricular experience to suit the myriad interests of our students. Our students excel in both performing and visual arts with equal elan. Their debating skills in both English and Hindi language is noteworthy. Their culinary skills are of national repute. I'm happy to share the co-curricular awards for this academic year, 2020-2021. The Sheza Nabi Trophy for Debating in English is shared by Woodpecker 382, Tarika Man, and Woodpecker 277, Ishanya Agarwal. The Shubhi Sharma Trophy for Excellence in Hindi Debating goes to Woodpecker 123, Medha Ajit Sarya. The Suresh Khanna Trophy Excellence in Art goes to Hupu 270, Jodhkar Thind. I'm happy to announce the Aisha Mayadas Award for Creativity, and this is shared by two wonderful students, Woodpecker 605, Shanvi Bansal, and Flycatcher 409, Vedika Bansal. The Sri Vasudev Rao Deshpande Trophy for Excellence in Music goes to Hupu 561, Ramana Prakash. The Ashna Gupta Trophy for Excellence in Dance goes to Woodpecker 191, Jaya Vats. The Award for Outstanding Achievement in Dramatics goes to Woodpecker 143, Anisha Mukesh Kedia. Very well done and keep it up, girls. In spite of COVID times, our students have participated in a number of competitions offered virtually and come out with flying colors. Sports is an integral part, and we believe a sound mind resides in a sound body. Wellham leaves no stone unturned to keep our students fit, enduring, and healthy. As you all know, the morning routine and exercise is something we religiously follow even in these challenging times. We offer 10 different types of sports, and our students have represented the state and at the national level in almost all sports. In recent years, the standard of sports has reached a new milestone, with several of our students bringing medals at the national level. The Shiraz and Sanjoli Trophy for Excellence in any field is awarded this year to one of our best athletes, flycatcher 003 Anahat Grewal. At Welham, we celebrate attitude equally as much as aptitude. True to our motto, we recognize students who go beyond the call of duty and give in their best at all times. This year's Anjana Lal Trophy for Helpfulness goes to Bulbul 230 Mrigya Kumar. Award for Service Beyond the Call of Duty goes to Flycatcher 377 Prisha Manocha. The Phool Kumari Award for Love and Compassion goes to Hupu 242 Arushi Agarwal, Captain of her house. The Shanti Verma Trophy for Perseverance was instituted last year in recognition of our beloved Mrs. Verma, former principal of Welham. This year, this prestigious award goes to Flycatcher 630 Vidhi Thapliya. I now come to the much awaited and the very prestigious awards, the Spirit of Welham Award and the Best Future Citizen Award. I'm happy to announce the Nina Kanta Aluwalia Cup for the Spirit of Welham this year goes to the school captain, Flycatcher 294 Hansika Nath. The Miss Linnell Gold Medal for the Best Future Citizen goes to Bulbul 070 Devangana Prasad, who's also the captain of Bulbul House. Congratulations to you both. None of this would be possible but for the dedicated efforts of our staff, whose sincere and committed services have maintained the standards of this legendary institution. Today, it is our honor and privilege to felicitate three members who have served this institution for the last 25 years. Welham has been a destination and home for several staff members. It is a very unique and heartening feature that very few members leave the fold. Most of the teachers as well as support staff sustain with us for decades, which stands testimony to the work ethics and atmosphere in this school. This year, the Long Service Award in the teaching staff category is being conferred upon Ms. Chavi Gupta, a fine teacher of accounts and commerce, an able and loving house mistress of the Bulbul House seniors, and currently the supervising examiner of ISC. She has been spearheading the Welham banking system for many, many years and is always ready to take up new challenges. Congratulations, Ms. Gupta. We are happy to award Sri Anil Kumar, electrician, and Srimati Sushila Devi, Safai Karamchari, the Long Service Award for this year. We thank you both for your committed service and wish you a longer, fruitful stint with us. Please give them a loud round of applause. Thank you. My dear students, I see this as a moment to thank you all and tell you how proud I am of each one of you for standing in solidarity and being a part of this learning, evolving experience in these COVID times. I can say that as true Welhamites, you have all emerged stronger and shown that you are capable of quickly adapting to even the most unfamiliar and unforeseen situation such as this pandemic. Now, to my dear senior students who will be leaving the portals in a few months, I want you to know that you are all very dear to me and I have missed the personal interaction with each one of you. The pandemic has truly reiterated the much cliched skills of 21st century, such as decision making, problem solving, ability to innovate, and most certainly, adaptability and conflict resolution, both within and without. We can say the pandemic has put all these skills to test in real time. The question is, how do we prepare ourselves further for situations that we cannot fully anticipate? My recommendation to you all would be the 4 R's to remember in the current circumstances. The first R, read. Keep yourself well informed. Be open-minded. Shed prejudices. Read and listen to a variety of viewpoints on a host of topics. Be in touch with the pulse of the changing times. Familiarize yourself with the changing formats of standardized tests and quiz templates. Develop strategies to ace your tests while you have the time. Draft a winning resume, which is well researched yet is an honest representation of yourself and your achievements. The second R, revamp. Streamline social media presence. This year, we have seen an unprecedented usage of the social media platforms by all age groups. Remember, we leave a lot of our digital footprint, which is currently used to assess our potential, both attitude and aptitude. Therefore, my dear students, clean up the posts on social media and be mindful of what you share, because these have lasting impressions of you and can directly impact your future. The third R, reinvent. Venture into new territories. This is the time to learn new things with gay abandon. It could be learning a new instrument or pursuing a new hobby, learning to code or developing new apps or videos, and rejoice through art and craft. Remember, the world tomorrow is looking for people who can multitask with a range of skills. Finally, the fourth R, and the most important, rise. It has been a relentless endeavor to help you all understand the importance of resilience and mental strength in order to face changes. Face changes with hope. Face changes with an attitude befitting the courageous. Face changes with an indomitable spirit, a spirit akin to Maya Angelou's words. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lines. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I will rise. Unquote. You must rise above all that is trifle, all that is self-serving. Rise above all that does not serve the collective goal. Remember our motto, Artha Shanti Phala Vidya, and live true to it. May your life reflect the essence of William Channing's My Symphony. I quote, to live content with small means, to seek elegance rather than luxury, and refinement rather than fashion, to be worthy, not respectable, and wealthy, not rich, to study hard, think quietly, talk gently, act frankly, to listen to stars, birds, babes, and sages with open heart, to bear all cheerfully, do all bravely, await occasions, hurry never. In a word, to let the spiritual, unbidden, and unconscious grow up through the common. This is to be my symphony, and quote, our symphony. Thank you all. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It is my privilege to now welcome Mr. Deepak Kapoor, President Vellum Girls School Society to kindly share his thoughts.
Okay, I'm audible now?
Yes, yes.
Well, thank you very much. And thank you, Mrs. Padmini Sambasivam, for the warm welcome earlier. And very good evening, dear parents, students, teachers, staff members, society members, Vinita, a dear friend and our chief guest today, and ladies and gentlemen. I'm absolutely and truly delighted to be a part of a school board such as Vellum. And I must say, I have thoroughly enjoyed my interactions and visits with the students and staff in the last 3 years. I consider it an absolute honor to have been elected the president of the board last month and having taken over from Vinita, who has been an extraordinary leader who helped steer the school to higher standards. She very ably led the board in shaping a vision for the school, which combined with the hard work of the principal and staff have ensured that the academic and extracurricular and co-curricular activities continue to be one of the best in the country and in fact rising to meet the international standards. The focus of the Board of Governors is to maintain the welfare of all stakeholders of the school, be it parents, students, or staff, and at all points of time. The last several months, as the principal said, have made all of us face unprecedented times, indeed difficult times, which have been full of challenges. And during these tough times, the school has risen to help all concerned in the best way possible. From reduction in fees to offering a much higher number of scholarships, maintaining staff and sub-staff increments, a number of proactive steps have been taken to counter this crisis and to keep the morale high. This institution called Vellum Girls School has stood strong behind each and every one to ensure that we collectively see all of us through the pandemic. And we are doing all that, ladies and gentlemen, not only because that is the right thing to do, but also because we firmly believe that the well-being of every member directly contributes to the welfare of the organization. And befitting the Vellum brand, the Board of Governors is committed to the highest levels of governance. And in addition to a robust review of systems and processes every now and then, we are also invested in supporting the principal and staff to do their jobs more effectively and more efficiently. In addition to academic excellence, we also lay emphasis on improving physical and virtual infrastructure and providing technology-embedded world-class amenities to our students. And the junior dorm and science labs are being redesigned and reconstructed with the best-in-class facilities. We are also constructing additional staff residences so that more and more staff members actually live on the campus. And at this point, I can't resist but congratulating the principal and the teaching and administrative staff for their dedicated and committed service, which has helped in maintaining the exemplary standards year after year, including during the last few months, despite some very visible challenges. The board has also always believed that engaging with and listening to the stakeholders is critical in improving things. And a few months back, we had conducted a survey among parents, and it was very heartening to see that over 90% of you have wholeheartedly supported the school with respect to the curriculum offered, efficient online teaching, inclusivity, and pastoral care, and providing a range of opportunities catering to variety of student interests. My dear parents, while we are delighted to receive accolades and appreciation from the majority of you, we are also studiously following up on the concerns expressed by some of you and are taking active and appropriate steps. We are committed to each one of you in bringing out the best in our daughters. Going forward, I would like to assure everyone that it would be my and indeed the board's sincere effort to push Vellum higher and higher to meet and indeed exceed global standards. I believe that today it is no longer best practices, but the next best practices that we have to chase to always remain ahead of the curve. And with that in mind, we are also investing in providing professional development and latest and advanced training to our teachers and staff. And to our dear students who are at the core of our attention and existence, I would like to say that the school would continue to explore new avenues and opportunities for you to widen your horizons in academics and beyond to live up to our motto, Artha Shanti Phala Vidya. The true aim of education is to spread peace. Let me finish by offering my compliments to one and all for the fantastic work done in spite of the unprecedented times. And I assure you all that the board will always be with you in your pursuit towards excellence. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring presence and support. I would now like to request Ms. Vinita Bali, our esteemed chief guest, to address the gathering.
Thank you very much. I am assuming till I hear somebody scream that I am audible. So, first of all, this evening, like all others, Founders Day, that all others founders days that I have been privy to, is more than anything else a tribute to the indomitable spirit of Vellum. It's a spirit that has impacted all of us over the years that we have been associated with Vellum. Whether we were students of Vellum or not, it didn't matter. There is a spirit of Vellum that permeates you the moment you get associated with the school. And before I begin, I must say a very warm and grateful thanks to Mrs. Brar, who insisted that I actually join the board of the Vellum School. And I was a little bit reluctant at first, not because I didn't want to, but because I hadn't actually been to school ever since I graduated from school, which was literally in the last century. And what brought me to Vellum and my association with Mrs. Brar, I have one other individual to thank, and that is a member of the Vellum board, a very dear friend, Sayyida Imam, who made sure somehow that I was the keynote speaker for the 50th anniversary celebrations of Vellum. And that traces back my association with Vellum, which I have cherished, which I will forever regard with the highest respect, and more than that, with a sense of camaraderie, with a sense of fun, where frankly, we all worked hard, played hard, learned from each other, and contributed to the welfare and the well-being of the school. I also want to begin by thanking Padmini for having me as the chief guest. And though I don't really deserve to be a guest at Vellum at all after all these years, I guess I have a sense of belonging with the school. So thank you for this opportunity to once again share some thoughts that I have with the students, with parents, with the teachers, and with everybody else who cares to listen. And of course, my fellow board members, who I have great admiration for. Thank you, Deepak, for your wonderful opening comments. And thank you to members of the board for being extremely supportive through some very unprecedented and unforeseen times that confronted us all in the form and shape of COVID. But more than anything else, it is a day for us to reflect. It is a day for us to be grateful. It is a day for us to be appreciative of everything that we have got. And it is a day for us to spend some time thinking about what does this day actually mean for each of us individually, in addition to what it means for each of us together. Of course, we are all missing the warm hospitality, the buzz, the vibrancy, the activity that surrounds Founders Day. You know, it is a ritual that we all got so used to. We used to arrive, we knew which rooms we were in. You know, we enjoyed the warmth and the hospitality of the entire Wellham staff, from the drivers who came to receive us at the airport, from the people who cooked for us, you know, ironed our clothes, made sure that we were there on time, the interaction that we had with other students of Wellham, you know, the AGM, a lot of those has been taken away from us in a physical sense. But the spirit of Wellham, the spirit of Founders Day, the spirit of what this event means cannot be taken away from us, because thanks to technology and thanks to how each of us bring our own interest and engagement and passion with this day, we will make this another memorable event. So my dear students, what is it that I can say to you? You have spent almost 9 months sitting in front of computer screens with people teaching you this and that. So do I want to share more words of wisdom and more gyan with you? The answer is absolutely no. I don't want to share anything with you that you could pick up a book or even Google, because I know several of you will Google. So what I thought the best I could do is to actually share what I think are 4 or 5 learnings, you may call them, insights, you may call them, points to consider and either remember or discard. The choice is yours. These are based on my own experiences of school, my own school that I went to, which was CGM in Delhi, and then LSR, and then, you know, various other universities. My experience with Wellham and what I have learned about primary school education, my experience with the wonderful teachers that I have interacted with, the principal, starting from Mrs. Brar, Mrs. Verma, actually, who I remember and miss dearly. If Mr. Verma is on this call, you know, my warm greetings to you. Ranbir and Jyotsna, who I got so used to meeting every year, of course, Padmini and Mr. Sambhasivam, you know, who have always been there, Padmini, your parents, and the cups of coffee that we've enjoyed. All of this makes Founders Day more than just Founders Day. It's not an interaction. It is a ritual. It is the warmth. It is the camaraderie. It is the friendship that this embodies, which is far more important than, you know, the interactions we might end up having. So what are these 4 or 5 things that I want to talk to you about? Let me start with the first. I want to call that ambition and competitiveness. And, you know, one of my big aha moments, and some of these I will illustrate through stories, but one of my big aha moments was that actually The only person we compete with through our life is ourselves. We don't compete with our batchmates. We don't compete with anybody. We simply compete with ourselves. And let me tell you why I'm saying this, and I will illustrate this with a story. I joined the Coca-Cola company at the end of 1994 and was lucky enough to be posted in Atlanta, which is the headquarters of Coke. My job was the worldwide marketing director for brand Coke. And those of you who are old enough to remember might remember that the 1996 Olympics happened in Atlanta, which is the heartland of Coke. Because I was the head of marketing for brand Coke, and because this was happening in Atlanta, I actually got to meet some of the greatest athletes, from Nadia Comaneci, who I actually spent a lot of time with. And I saw the athletes in training. And the one thing that impacted me the most was, were any of these people looking at what somebody else scored? Absolutely not. They were practicing. They were, if they were sprinters, they were running. If they were gymnasts, they were doing their, bars or whatever they were doing. Did they bother to check anybody else's score? The answer is no. All they were interested in was improving on their own score. And I stopped and I thought about it, and I still think about that. And I keep saying that if we could only realize very early on in life that our only competition is with ourselves, there is nothing that I can do to make you worse off, but there is everything that I can do to make myself better off. And if I make myself better off, then, you will fall wherever you fall, and I will fall wherever I fall. So my first insight, really, that I actually very strongly believe in and live by, is that it's great to be ambitious. It is great to be competitive. But remember that at the end of the day, you are only competing with yourself, because the only person that you can work with is yourself. You know, Madame Curie, who was my hero when I was growing up, she continues to be my hero for a variety of reasons. I remember reading a quote of hers which said that nothing in life is to be feared. It is only to be understood. And if we understand, and the purpose of understanding more is that we may fear less. I think that is as true of any discipline as it is about the present situation that we are living in. Does anybody have a definitive answer to COVID? I don't know of anybody. The scientists are trying. We are close to, getting a virus and all of that. But the only way we got to it is through knowledge. The only way we got to it is through application of that knowledge, not through fear. And I think if we live our life to say that we want to live a life of understanding and not of fear, it changes a lot of things. Padmini talked about, attitude and aptitude. I think both of those are very, very important. Your attitude and your aptitude will determine how you react to things, how all of us react to things. Again, Maya Angelou has been quoted, another one of my heroes, who said that you may not control all the events that happen to you, but you can decide not to be reduced by them. She could have said it in a different context, and she did say them in a different context, but I still think it is important how we respond to something. To a large extent determines how we will deal with adversity, how we will deal with ambiguity, how we will deal with complexity. And nobody sitting here today can say what our planet will be like 6 months from now, a year from now, 20 years from now. All we can do is prepare ourselves to live a life of responsibility and to live a life that focuses on knowledge, on understanding, on compassion and empathy, which is my second insight. So if the first one was ambition and competitiveness, the second one is compassion and empathy. And here again, I want to illustrate this by sharing a story that had a deep impact on me. And this is a very recent story. This is a story that takes place when we see images of hundreds of people who were working in the city's walk. Not hundreds of people, hundreds of thousands of people working in the cities walk hundreds of miles or bicycle hundreds of miles back to their villages. And there were issues of, you know, do they have enough to eat? Where is nutrition? Where is water? And so on. And there was a program actually that Barkha Dutt did where she was interviewing women from a society in a place in Surat. And this one woman related the story, which I think hits the bullseye on compassion and empathy, at least for me. And she said that one evening she was cooking for her family and she was making chapatis. And the thought struck her that what will it take if she makes 10 or 12 extra chapatis? And she said, I'm cooking for my family. It will probably take me another 12 or 15 minutes to make 10 or 12 extra chapatis. And then she said, I thought to myself, what if all of us who are living in this very large complex were to do the same? So she said she spoke to some friends and neighbors and they all decided to do that. And you will not believe, for 4 months, these women supplied 150,000 chapatis to migrants. They coordinated with NGOs who would come and collect these chapatis. Some of them even said that once in a while they would put 50 or 100 rupees in between these chapatis, saying, "Jiski kismat mein hai, usko chapati to milegi, 50-100 rupees bhi hamare se mil jaye, to unka to kuch usse fayda hoga." This is compassion and empathy. It is not about being a millionaire or a billionaire. Compassion requires a big heart. It does not require big bucks. Though my appeal to those people who have the big bucks is create the big hearts, because you can make a very big difference with a big heart and big bucks. So that's my second insight. The third is something which is sort of more personal, and that is really about saying to you or sharing with you that life will throw many choices out at you. First of all, don't believe that there is a famine of opportunities. In fact, there is a flood of opportunities. There are almost too many choices that each of us have. And sometimes choice actually leads to confusion. The only way I have found of reducing the confusion in choices is to truly ask yourself the question that, is this something that you really want to do? Is this something that you can really learn from? And is this something that you believe you will have fun doing? Whether it is the choice of the university that you go to, this is for those of you who are going to graduate from the 12th standard and go to college. Whether it is the choice of career, you want to be a doctor, don't allow, and this is a message as much for the parents as it is for the students. The last thing anybody should do to anybody else, whether you're a parent, a sibling, a teacher, a principal, a neighbor, I don't care who you are, is to force somebody. You can educate them. You can give them a bigger perspective. You can throw the choices and consequences open to them. But for God's sake, don't make a decision on someone else's behalf, saying that I have seen more of the world than you have. You know, this world is changing so fast that the world those of us in our 60s have seen is not going to be the world that those of you in the 20s are going to inhabit. So what is important is prepare your daughters or your students or yourselves, and this is where I'm talking to the students, for a world that you will enjoy and embrace. And the only way you can enjoy and embrace something is to do what you really and truly want to do. You can only create excellence when you're enjoying yourself. Excellence is not created by living on the basis of someone else's decision. That applies to you today as a student. It will apply to you tomorrow when you make career choices, when you make choices on whether you want to get married or not get married, the kind of partner you want to choose to marry or not marry. There are all kinds of decisions that we are making all the time. All I know is that if you make a decision that you truly want to invest your time and your life in, then make a decision that works for you. Be guided by a whole lot of people, but don't be confused by them. And the last point I want to make is on the purpose of education. I've thought about this a lot, and I must say that Wilhelm has contributed a lot to my going back to thinking about the purpose of education in primary school. And my conclusion really is that it doesn't matter what happens to our education later on in life. Our character is molded in primary schools. And therefore, my request to all the teachers of Wilhelm and the teachers who are not in Wilhelm and the parents who are also teachers and the siblings who are also teachers and the board of governors who are also teachers in their own way. I think we all have to remember one thing, that if the purpose of education is not to get 95% marks and get into a good school, you know, if we create a mind that is an open mind, and if we create an environment where these open minds can do their best work and their best thinking, then education would have served its purpose. The purpose of education is to liberate. The purpose of education is to create an open mind, not a closed mind. The purpose of education is to create an open mind that has the ability to weigh the consequences and that has the ability to discriminate. And therefore, the purpose of educators is to provide that context, is to provide that environment where minds can be molded to have conviction, where minds can be molded to be open to influences, where minds can be molded to think for themselves and not to be led astray just because everybody else is doing this. And my last point is, don't do something because everybody is doing it. Do it because you want to do it. Because at the end of the day, all of us live with ourselves before we live with anybody else. So with these few thoughts, I wish all of you the very best. Dear students, parents, you know, to enjoy the students, you have them at home, which is a rare occasion. Teachers, you always do your best. I know you have children who are students. Padmini, the board, everybody else. And once again, my grateful thanks to all of you who have given me this opportunity to share my thoughts. Take what makes sense to you and discard the rest. That is also a choice. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bali and Mr. Deepak Kapoor, for your inspirational words. A very warm good evening to our Honorable Chief Guest, respected Board of Governors, Mrs. Sambasivam, all staff, parents, and my fellow Wellamites. I have to start by admitting that as I stand here at this podium today, I am extremely nervous. And I think most of that nervousness stems out from the realization that I don't have a precedent to look up to. Because no one has actually done founders this way before. Not to mention that my only audience tonight is the walls and the camera. And unfortunately, it's a little hard to get a hoot out of them. But I hope whichever corner of the world you are sitting in today, I'm able to get at least some claps from you. Well, yes, 2020 has been a year of some turbulent emotions. And not just for me, but for everyone. Our SCs and a few teachers lost their last year at school. Our new B2s haven't stepped onto the Vellum Bajri yet. And for the first time, as I stand on this stage, school feels empty. I became who I am today back in 2013 on a sunny April afternoon when I was 10. Two pigtails, a chunni that didn't stay on my shoulders, and some knee-high socks. That was my first day at school. I always wanted to come to boarding school, but I never expected to remain junior most for 2 long years, wash my own socks in the cold Dehradun winter, drink horrible cocoa at 5 a.m., make my own bed, or take uphills on these auditorium stairs, while Mr. Bachhani's words echoed in the back. Rain, hail, or storm, basketball is always on. But today, I am so grateful for exactly these memories. Vellum taught me the little things matter. If you can't do the little things right, you can't do the big things. And somewhere along the way, intermingled with a little bit of debating, writing, and music, I shed the pigtails, my chunni fell in the right place, and my socks reached an acceptable length. I want to read out something I wrote to my parents back in B3s. Dear Mama and Papa, I beg you both with folded hands, please, 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 take me out. Now I have realized your real importance. Please respond and help me fast. I am waiting for you. And it was signed, Hansika in Trouble. My purpose of standing here and reminiscing these seemingly frivolous anecdotes is to show to everyone that every single one of you has your own story of glory to weave. Vellum taught me to love and to lose, to rise and to fall. But most importantly, it made me realize that life isn't always peaches and cream. Passing my captaincy through the pandemic, there were days when everything seemed futile. But life goes on, with or without it. Vellum taught me to stop at the right stations, be resilient, face my biggest fears, conquer them, and come out stronger. With each day and each moment spent within these brick walls, you become a new person. The greatest glory in living here lies not in never falling, but in rising every time you fall. To all parents who sit today in uncertainty about the future of their daughters and this institution, I say when there is no hope, it is imperative for us to invent it. And trust me when I say this, Vellum is the home of hopes. To my fellow Vellumites, I suppose I can't impart the best advice, I'm merely learning myself. But if I had to, I'd say it's very easy to sit and criticize what's happening in the world. Vellum teaches us to go beyond ourselves and take conscious action for the things that really matter. It teaches us to become global citizens. Being a Vellumite is not just wearing these tadpoles. It is a massive responsibility to both this school and to the world. This institution has a voice, and dare I say, a rather powerful one. I urge you all to hone your skills, utilize this platform, become proactive, and make a difference towards the causes you believe in. Because at the end of the day, standing for what you believe in is what matters most. I urge you all to learn to empathize, learn to forgive, learn to move on. And most importantly, feel grateful for this family. Because once you move away from school, you realize that home isn't just a place anymore. It is a feeling. And how lucky we are to have another home away from home. This speech, like my journey at Vellum, would be incomplete without mentioning those who mentored and supported me through it all. Mrs. Anima Singh and Ms. Joshi for pulling me through B3s. Ms. Gurnam Kaur and Ms. Savinder Kaur for being my backbone. To Ms. Deepti Kumar for not just being my house mistress, but my house mother. To those who stayed, Dr. Neera Kapoor, Dr. Nalanda Pandey, Dr. Roma Saklani, Dr. Chavi Jain, Mrs. Gitanjali Bhatia, Mrs. Jyoti Vasudev, Mrs. Rita Vasudev, Mrs. Subohi Rashid, and to all those who left, Ms. Aarti Seth, Ms. Mamta Gautam, Mrs. Brar, and Mrs. Datta. And to every single staff member who in his or her own way has changed my life, I want to take this opportunity to thank you from the bottom of my heart. To the sports department and Mr. Bachani, sir, the lessons you imparted may not have been reflected by me on court, but I assure you, they will always be implemented in my life. I would also like to express my immense gratitude to the music department, the dramatics department, to Ms. Geeta Sharma for being the most amicable face around campus, to Mrs. Samba Sivam for backing me unconditionally and teaching me the sense of leadership. To every Didi and every Bairaji, aapke bina to kuch bhi nahi ho pata, especially the extra french fries. To my squad, the captain body, thank you for uniting in everything, including our WhatsApp sticker mania. To my fly catchers, Jia, Ria, Ridhima, Ved, Sarasha, Navya, for always fueling me with their midnight feasts. To Ishanya, Mehnoor, Banjo, and Medha for being my constants. To Taraka for being my best friend and my worst rival. To the girls who turned into women, the friends that turned into family, and the kingfishers that dive deep and soared to high. To my batch of 2021, I cannot thank you enough for embracing my service as your school captain. It might be our time to go, but at least we stole the show. And finally, to the most important people. It was class 6 when I was asked to compete with some seniors on this very stage, an inter-house declamation competition. I was so petrified, so much so that I was on the verge of backing out. I called up home, crying, and they said, "What was the worst thing that could happen to you, Hansika? You would lose. So what? Big deal." I was told to give it a shot, and Mama Papa, I did give it a shot. Luckily for me, I won. You're the wind beneath my wings, the calm in every storm, and the anchor that helps me hold my ground. I know I don't say it too often, but I love you unconditionally. Thank you for making my miracles happen. I know I'm a difficult one to handle, but I promise you, one day I'll make you so, so proud. Because the smile on your face right now, even though I can't see it, is so precious. I know there are people who say all these things don't matter, and there are people who forget what it's like to be B3s once you turn into SCs. I know these moments will all be stories someday, and our pictures will become old photographs. And one day, we'll all be someone's mom. But right now, these moments are not stories. This is happening. I am here. I am in my home. I can see it. This one moment I know I will walk out without any regrets. And as I look around and see the fairy lights in the Nasreen, the same bajri under my feet, and remember listening to music in the senior garden on after-dinner walks with the people I love most in this world, and everything else that makes me wonder, I swear, Vellum, in these moments, we are infinite. We are infinite. Thank you, everyone, and have a good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, with this, we come to the end of the first segment of today's program. At this juncture, I must take the time to mention that executing the cultural program online has not been easy. Many local students were brought into school to prepare and record themselves. Our music and dance, dramatics and IT departments have worked relentlessly, both on screen and behind the scenes, to make this program a success. And evidently, it has reflected the spirit of oneness. It is now time for you to sit back and enjoy Samashti, an ensemble.
Ajju, dekha tumne, maaj phir kis tarah se shunya mein taak rahi hai. Mujhe bahut dar lag raha hai. Kahin mamma depression mein na chali jaye.
Haan, Asha, maa ne apne charo aur ye kaisa ghera bana liya hai. कि हम में से कोई भी उसमें जा नहीं पा रहा है, यहाँ तक कि पापा ने भी हार मान ली है। मैं तो कितनी बार कह चुका हूँ कि she needs professional help।
अज्जू, मुझे पता है, लेकिन माँ तो professional help देने के लिए बिल्कुल भी तैयार नहीं है। वो सोचती है हम सब उन्हें पागल समझते हैं।
खैर, मैं फिर कोशिश करता हूँ।
ऐसा क्यों होता है? आदमी ना हंसता है ना रोता है, क्यों मान लेता है कि चारों तरफ है अंधकार? ऐसी स्थिति को क्यों कर लेता है स्वीकार?
हाँ जी बताइए।
बताने को कुछ नहीं है, बस बच्चों के कहने पर आ गई हूँ, कुछ भी समझने या समझाने में ना कामयाब हूँ।
पर कहने को कुछ तो होगा।
मन अशांत है, विचलित है, जीवन में बिखराव है। ऐसा लगता है जैसे सब टूट रहा है, छूट रहा है। मंजिल नहीं, किनारा नहीं, पतवार नहीं, मांझी नहीं।
मैम, मैं आपसे कुछ प्रश्न पूछूंगा, क्या आप जवाब देंगी?
पूछिए।
क्या आपको नींद नहीं आती?
नहीं आती डॉक्टर साहब, मुझे नींद नहीं आती। जब मैं देखती हूँ कचरा बीनते हुए नौ निहालों को, रोटी के एक एक टुकड़े को तरसते हुए उन सूखे पीले चेहरों को, हाँ मुझे नींद नहीं आती। जब किसी बच्ची के बलात्कार की खबर सुनती हूँ, या फिर रात के अंधकार में किसी मासूम का दाह संस्कार होते देखती हूँ, और तो और पुलिस और सियासत के बंधे हुए मुंह और बंधे हुए हाथ देखती हूँ, मुझे नींद कैसे आ सकती है?
और चक्कर, क्या चक्कर भी आते हैं आपको?
चक्कर क्यों नहीं डॉक्टर हितेश, चक्कर आते हैं। चक्कर तब आते हैं जब वोट के लिए जनता को बिकते हुए देखती हूँ, जब देखती हूँ आप और हम जैसे पढ़े लिखे लोग वोट देने ही नहीं जाते, ये सोचकर चक्कर आते हैं। ऐसे में कौन तय करता है कि who is actually capable to lead us?
बस कीजिए, आपने तो मेरी अंतरात्मा को ही झंझोड़ कर रख दिया है। ये सब तो मेरे साथ भी होता है, पर मैं कुछ कह नहीं पाता। ये सब देखकर सुनकर मेरी भी रूह कांपती है। मैं भी तो रातें जागकर बिताता हूँ जब अपने देश के होनहार युवाओं को फांसी के फंदे पर झूलते हुए देखता हूँ, और सोचता हूँ भगत सिंह, सुखदेव, राजगुरु, ये भी तो फांसी के फंदे पर झूले थे, पर भारत माँ की आजादी के लिए। अब यही सैक्रिफाइस, यही शहादत किस लिए?
ये शहादत किस लिए? क्या इसलिए कि उनके आत्मसम्मान को ठेस पहुंची, या इसलिए कि समाज ने उनके हुनर को पहचाना नहीं, या इसलिए कि उन्होंने जिंदगी से कुछ ज्यादा ही मांग लिया?
मुझे भी चक्कर आते हैं।
क्या आपको भी चक्कर आते हैं? जब लोग अपनी उलझनों से भागकर नशीले पदार्थों का सहारा लेते हैं, समाज को भटकाते हैं और उन्हीं को हम अपना आदर्श मान लेते हैं। मेरी आंखों के सामने अंधेरा छा जाता है जब धर्म और जाति के नाम पर दो प्रेमियों को जिंदा जला दिया जाता है, या फिर पेड़ों से लटका दिया जाता है। सवाल दर सवाल।
क्या आप सब भी वही सोच रहे हैं जो हम सोच रहे हैं? क्या आप भी वही? तो क्या हम सब एक सा सोचते हैं? हम सबकी सोच एक सी ही है? Do we all think alike? Do we have similar thoughts? That means there is an element of oneness in our thinking.
पर लगता है हम ही गांधी जी के सच्चे बंदर हैं।
बुरा देखते हैं पर अपना मुंह बंद रखते हैं, बुरा सुनते हैं फिर भी अपना मुंह बंद रखते हैं, बस अब और नहीं।
हम क्यों नपुंसक बनते जा रहे हैं, क्यों स्वार्थी बनते जा रहे हैं? हजारों सवाल, सवाल दर सवाल,
सवाल दर सवाल, सवाल दर सवाल। युग है भ्रष्टाचार का, युग है भ्रष्टाचार का, बिकता है मीडिया। युग है भ्रष्टाचार का।
बिकता है नेता, बिकता है अभिनेता,
बिकता है इंसाफ,
सब बिकता है।
युग है बोलती खामोशी का। हजारों सवाल, सवाल दर सवाल, सवाल दर सवाल।
Thank you.
कौन हो तुम? सवालों के इस जंगल में तुम क्या कर रही हो?
मुझे नहीं पहचाना, मैं हूँ रागिनी। मैंने तुम्हारी बातचीत सुनी है। तुम जिन सवालों की बात कर रही हो वो तो युगों युगों से चले आ रहे हैं। क्या द्वापर, क्या त्रेता, क्या त्रेता युग में सीता का अपहरण नहीं हुआ? क्या द्वापर में द्रौपदी का अपमान नहीं हुआ? क्या तब भीष्म मौन नहीं रहे थे? क्या धृतराष्ट्र दुर्योधन के प्रेम में न्याय और अन्याय का अंतर नहीं भूल गए थे? तब से अब तक कुछ भी तो नहीं बदला है, कुछ भी नहीं।
रागिनी तुम भूल रही हो, उस युग में तो
मैं तुम्हारा मतलब समझ गई। तुम कहना चाहती हो कि उस युग में तो राम ने, कृष्ण ने जन्म लिया था और अब आज की सीता को, आज की द्रौपदी को।
हाँ, इस युग में कौन हमारा सहारा बनेगा, कौन हमारा सहारा बनेगा, कौन हमारा उद्धार करेगा, कौन?
अब हमें किसी अवतार का इंतजार करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है। अब हमें स्वयं सुदर्शन चक्र उठाना होगा। हमें अपनी लड़ाई खुद लड़नी होगी। हमें स्वयं अवतार बनना होगा।
हाँ, हमें स्वयं सुदर्शन चक्र उठाना होगा। हमें स्वयं सुदर्शन चक्र उठाना होगा।
सही कहा रागिनी, तुमने बिल्कुल सही कहा है। हमें अपनी लड़ाई खुद लड़नी होगी। समंदर नहीं, एक घूंट पानी ही काफी है प्यास बुझाने को। समंदर नहीं, एक घूंट पानी ही काफी है प्यास बुझाने को। जलता हुआ सूरज नहीं, एक दिया ही काफी है अंधेरा मिटाने को, अंधेरा मिटाने को।
तुम?
मैं? मोहिनी, रागिनी, मुझे तुम्हारी बातें बहुत अच्छी लग रही हैं। और मेरा भी यही मानना है कि हमें निराश होने की जगह समाज में फैल रहे स्वार्थ को, अमीर गरीब के अंतर को, जाति भेद को, रंग भेद को, सबको स्वयं दूर करना होगा। हर सीता को, हर द्रौपदी को अपनी लड़ाई खुद लड़नी होगी।
लेकिन ये कैसे हो सकता है?
जो बीमारी हमारे समाज में कैंसर की तरह फैल चुकी है, उसका इलाज कैसे होगा?
होगा, बिल्कुल होगा। इसके लिए हमें अपनी सोच में और अपने नजरिए में परिवर्तन लाना होगा।
Which means that when we begin to tolerate one another, everything will be fine. Am I right?
Perhaps you may be right. But in my opinion, instead of tolerating one another, we must learn to accept one another. समाज में परिवर्तन लाने के लिए हमें विभिन्नताओं को स्वीकार करना होगा। और ये तब हो सकता है जब हर एक परिवार और हर एक विद्यालय में इस बात पर ध्यान दिया जाए।
परिवार में तो ये संभव है, पर स्कूल्स में विभिन्नताओं को स्वीकार करना कैसे सिखाया जा सकता है?
ये बात हम वेलम में शिक्षा के माध्यम से बड़ी ही सरलता से सीखते हैं। किताबों के अलावा बहुत से ऐसे आर्ट फॉर्म्स हैं, जैसे नाट्य कला, नृत्य कला, संगीत कला और चित्रकला भी।
और खेल के मैदान में जब हम अपने नहीं अपनी टीम के लिए खेलते हैं, तब हम स्वार्थ के दायरे से बाहर निकलते हैं।
और यही मैदान हमें सिखाता है कि हार और जीत हमारे जीवन का हिस्सा है, फिर ये इंसानी रिश्तों में ही क्यों ना हो।
स्कूल से, कैन यू गिव मी एन एग्जांपल टू प्रूव योर पॉइंट?
व्हाई नॉट। नृत्य के चाहे कितने ही अलग अलग फॉर्म्स क्यों ना हो, किंतु द स्पिरिट बिहाइंड ईच डांस फॉर्म इज द सेम।
एक एक गुरु करे पुकार, जिसकी गूंज सुने सारा संसार। विभिन्न नृत्यों में है एक ही आत्मा की झंकार, एक ही आत्मा की झंकार।
Oh. Thank you.
पहली बार मैंने तीन अलग नृत्यों में थिरकती एक आत्मा देखी। अमीर खुसरो ने ठीक ही कहा है, अपनी छवि बनाए के मैं पी के पास गई, जब छवि देखी पी की अपनी भूल गई, अपनी भूल गई।
लेकिन अलग अलग डांस फॉर्म्स में एक रूपता को देखना या समझना आसान है, परंतु रियल लाइफ में हम अपने स्वार्थ से बाहर निकल ही नहीं पाते हैं, हम डिफरेंसेस को स्वीकार ही नहीं कर पाते हैं। ऐसा क्यों होता है?
हम शायद मोहिनी की बात का मतलब नहीं समझ पाए। शी इज ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन टू अस दैट वी हैव टू ट्रेन आवरसेल्व्स टू एक्सेप्ट डिफरेंसेस, डिफरेंस ऑफ कास्ट, कलर, क्रीड, ओपिनियन, रिच पुअर, मैन वुमन। दिस कैन ओनली बी डन इन आवर फॉर्मेटिव इयर्स। वी हैव टू बी स्ट्रांग फ्रॉम विद इन। हमें अपने भीतर समष्टि का भाव लाना होगा, अहम यानी कि ईगो या मैं के भाव से निकलकर सबको स्वीकारना होगा, तभी जीवन रूपी संगीत मधुर बनेगा, चारों तरफ आनंद की निर्मल धारा बहेगी।
एब्सोल्युटली सर, यू हैव सेड इट ऑल। लुक एट म्यूजिक, जस्ट एज ऑल साउंड इज नॉट म्यूजिक बट हार्मोनियसली कोऑर्डिनेटेड साउंड मेक्स म्यूजिक। Our school's Geet Pustika has a collection of hymns and prayers. Whether we invoke Allah, Ishwar, Waheguru, or Jesus, the spirit is the same.
The spirit is the same. The spirit is the same.
Sabhi prarthnaon ke piche chhipa bhav us tak pahunch jata hai.
Us tak pahunch jata hai. Us tak pahunch jata hai.
Da da da. Sani, sani, da, da, ni, da, pa, pa, da, ma, ga, re, sa. Sani, sani, da, da, ni.
Ladies and gentlemen, I request you all to kindly rise for the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, I request you all to kindly rise for the national anthem. Thank you, everyone. With this, we come to the end of the 63rd Founders Day celebrations. I would like to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for your unstinting support through these trying times and for investing your faith in this institution. Your presence, participation, and encouragement have largely contributed to make today's program a success. Thank you and good night till we meet again.